International humanitarian law protects people around the world by limiting suffering caused by war. The 1949 Geneva Conventions, agreed to by countries worldwide, draw clear distinctions between those who are fighting and those who are not, such as the wounded, civilians, and prisoners of war. They continue to address the challenges that people and societies face as a result of modern warfare. The first convention protects wounded and sick soldiers. It guarantees humane treatment, medical care, and protection from violence, including murder and torture. It ensures the collection of the sick, wounded, and dead while protecting medical personnel and facilities. The convention recognizes the Red Cross and Red Crescent as visible signs of protection. The second convention adapts the first to armed forces at sea, the wounded, sick, and shipwrecked. The third convention protects prisoners of war. POWs must be treated humanely and notably never be murdered or tortured. They must not be subjected to sexual violence. Women and other POWs facing particular risks benefit from specific protections. POWs must be provided with adequate food, water, clothing, shelter, and medical attention. They must be allowed to write home, to be visited by the ICRC, and be released without delay after the cessation of active hostilities. The fourth convention protects civilians, particularly those in the hands of an adversary. Protected civilians must be treated humanely. Acts such as murder or torture are never permitted. They must not be subjected to sexual violence. Groups that face particular risks, including women and children, are specifically protected. An occupying power must, as much as possible, ensure the population's food and medical supplies. The convention has rules on humanitarian relief and protects interned civilians, including the ICRC's right to visit. The conventions must be applied without discrimination, whatever, for example, a person's race, sex, nationality, religion, or political opinion. While the conventions govern international armed conflicts, those between states, Article 3 common to the conventions provides fundamental protections in all non-international armed conflicts, those involving non-state parties. This is essential as such conflicts today represent the majority. Three additional protocols widen the Convention's safeguards. Protocol 1 on international armed conflicts articulates key principles for the conduct of hostilities, among other important protections. Protocol 2 contains vital rules for certain non-international armed conflicts, and Protocol 3 recognizes the Red Crystal as an additional emblem. Customary international law complements the treaties in all types of armed conflicts. International humanitarian law upholds humanity in conflict. It seeks to prevent the worst at the worst of times. When respected, it can avoid the creation of insurmountable grievances, making it easier to return to peace.